Dear students, today I am going to teach about Jarif fourth lesson, Resource of India. In this lesson, we have to teach about what is natural resource, what are the types of natural resource, what are the importance of natural resource, what is the expansion of NALCO, what is called metallic minerals, example of metallic minerals, what is called a non-metallic minerals, example of non-metallic minerals. Then we have to discuss about mica, limestone, gypsum, coal, petroleum, minister of petroleum and natural gas, oil fields which are found in the western coastal plain, oil fields which are belonging to eastern coastal plain, nuclear power programs, thermal power programs. All these topics we have to discuss one by one properly. Today I am going to teach about geography, fourth lesson, Resource of India. In this lesson, first we have to discuss about what are the natural resource, what are the classification of natural resource, what are the importance of natural resource. We have to discuss all these things very briefly. What is natural resource? Any resource or energy or object or substance which is derived from environment to satisfy the basic needs of the living things or human being. It is called natural resource. Example of natural resource: all types of plants, animals, human beings, minerals, fossil fuels, solar energy, yarn, soil, water. These are all the best example of natural resource. Natural resource can be classified into two categories, such as renewable natural resource, non-renewable natural resource. Renewable natural resource are eco-friendly resource, pollution-free resource. They are non-conventional resources. They are found in abundant measures. After mass consumption, renewable resource cannot be lost. These resources can be utilized often and often. This type of resource can be reproduced and replenished. Non-renewable resource. Non-renewable resources are conventional resources. They cause pollution. They are found in scarce measures. After mass consumption of non-renewable resources, they may be lost. They cannot be increased often and often. In between renewable and non-renewable, renewable resource should be utilized for present generation. Non-renewable resource should be used only for future generation. That's why we must conserve and preserve non-renewable resource for the future demands. Renewable resource should be used always. After mass consumption of renewable resource, they may be reproduced again and again. What are the importance of natural resource? Natural resource are used as a raw material for industries. Natural resource are used for manufacturing of entire goods in the industries. they are very important for economic growth, industrial growth, agriculture growth. These resources only which determine the entire life of the people, generation of employment, mend the life of the people, provide a prosperity life of the country. It is very essential for entire growth of the nation. That's why all people have to give more importance for conservation and reservation of the natural resource. We should protect these resources free from pollution, free from disaster. Without natural resource, there is no life. Without natural resource, there is no economical growth. One who utilizes natural resource, he will be a resourceful person. One who doesn't use the natural resource, he will be poor. Utilization of natural resource is very important for enrichment of the life of the people. Next day, we should discuss about NALCO. NALCO stands for National Aluminium Corporation of India Limited. It was incorporated in 1981. It was incorporated in Odisha. It is under the control of Ministry of Mines, Government of India. It is a public sector. It is more responsible for generation of power, exploration, distribution, marketing, export, import, allocation, mining, maintaining, production of entire aluminium product in India. What is the expansion of NALCO? National Aluminium Corporation of India Limited. When it was incorporated? 1981. When and where it was incorporated? In Odisha. Then metallic mineral. What is metallic mineral? Mineral which contains metal content in them is called metallic mineral. Metallic mineral example, gold, copper, iron are best example of metallic mineral. Non-metallic mineral, in this mineral do not contain metal content in them, is called non-metallic mineral. Example, mica, limestone, gypsum are best example of non-metallic mineral. What is metallic mineral? Mineral which contains metal content in them is called metallic mineral. Best example of metallic mineral, gold, copper, iron are best example of metallic mineral. What is called non-metallic mineral? Non-metallic mineral which do not contain mineral content, do not contain metal content in the minerals, is called non-metallic mineral. What are the examples of non-metallic minerals? Mica, limestone and gypsum. What is called mica? What are the importance of mica? Mica is one of the non-metallic mineral. During ancient time, it was used for manufacturing of Ayurvedic medicine. It was largely utilized in electrical industry. It is exclusively used in electrical goods. It is a bad conductor of electricity. Copper is a good conductor of electricity. Mica is a bad conductor of electricity. Mica is a non-conductor of electricity. It is used for manufacturing of lubricants, medicine, paint and varnish. In India, 41% of the mica deposit in Andhra Pradesh. 21% of the mica deposit in Rajasthan. 20% of the mica deposit has been found in Odisha. India contributes 60% of the total production of the mica in the world. In India, Abrog is the best quality of mica. What types of mica? Mica is a non-conductor of electricity. It is one of the non-metallic minerals, which is a good conductor of electricity, copper, which is a non-conductor of electricity, mica. When was mica used for Ayurvedic medicine? During the time of ancient, where it is largely utilized, electrical industry. Name the products are made up of mica: lubricants, medicine, paint and varnish. Which is a leading producer of mica? Andhra Pradesh. Because 41% of the mica deposit has been found in only Rajasthan, only Andhra Pradesh. That's why Andhra Pradesh is a leading producer of mica. Name the country which contributes 60% of the total production of the mica in the world. India. Which is the best quality of mica? Abrog. Then limestone. Limestone also one of the non-metallic mineral. It contains small quantity of sulfur, silica, aluminum, iron oxide, phosphorus and sulfur. Limestone is also one of the non-metallic mineral. It contains small quantity of silica, aluminum, iron oxide, phosphorus and sulfur. This mineral is largely utilized in chemical industries. It is used for manufacturing of soda ash, caustic soda, bleaching powder, paper, cement, iron and steel, glass and fertilizers. In India, 20% of the limestone is deposited in Andhra Pradesh. 20% of the limestone deposit in Telangana. 18% of the limestone deposit has been found in Rajasthan. 12% of the limestone deposit has been found in Jammu and Kashmir. In Tamil Nadu, 8.4% of the limestone deposit is available in Tamil Nadu. 27% of the limestone deposit is available in Karnataka. Among the limestone producers, Karnataka is the principal producer of limestone. What does limestone contain? Limestone contains small quantity of silica, aluminum, iron oxide, phosphorus and sulfur. Where it is largely used in chemical industries. Name the products are manufactured. Name the products are made up of limestone. Soda ash, caustic soda, bleaching powder, paper, సిమెంట్ ఫర్టిలైజర్ గ్లాస్ ఐరన్ అండ్ స్టీల్ విచ్ ఈస్ ఎ లీడింగ్ ప్రొడ్యూసర్ ఆఫ్ లైమ్ స్టోన్ రాజస్థాన్ బికాస్ ఇన్ రాజస్థాన్ ఐ మీన్ కర్ణాటక నాట్ రాజస్థాన్ కర్ణాటక రీజన్ 21% ఆఫ్ ద లైమ్ స్టోన్ డెపాసిట్ ఈస్ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ కర్ణాటక కర్ణాటక ఈస్ ఎ లీడింగ్ ప్రొడ్యూసర్ ఆఫ్ లైమ్ స్టోన్ ఇన్ ఇండియా నెక్స్ట్ జిప్సమ్ జిప్సమ్ ఈస్ ఆల్సో వన్ ఆఫ్ ద నాన్ మెటాలిక్ మినరల్ ఇట్ కంటైన్స్ లైమ్ స్టోన్ శాండ్ స్టోన్ అండ్ సేల్ దిస్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ మినరల్ ఈస్ యూస్డ్ ఫార్ మ్యానుఫ్యాక్చరింగ్ ఆఫ్ సిమెంట్ ఫర్టిలైజర్ వాల్ బోర్డ్ ప్లాస్టర్ ఆఫ్ ప్యారిస్ జిప్సమ్ ఈస్ లార్జ్లీ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ రాజస్థాన్ 81% 81% ఆఫ్ ద టోటల్ డెపాసిట్ ఆఫ్ జిప్సమ్ ఈస్ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ రాజస్థాన్ 14% ఆఫ్ ద డెపాసిట్ ఆఫ్ జిప్సమ్ ఈస్ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ జమ్మూ అండ్ కాశ్మీర్ 2% ఇన్ తమిళనాడు 3% ఇన్ రిమైనింగ్ స్టేట్స్ ఆల్ ఓవర్ ఇండియా విచ్ ఈస్ ద ప్రిన్సిపల్ ప్రొడ్యూసర్ ఆఫ్ జిప్సమ్ రాజస్థాన్ రీజన్ 81% ఆఫ్ ద టోటల్ జిప్సమ్ డెపాసిట్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ రాజస్థాన్ రాజస్థాన్ ఈస్ ద ప్రిన్సిపల్ ప్రొడ్యూసర్ ఆఫ్ జిప్సమ్ వాట్ డస్ జిప్సమ్ కంటైన్ జిప్సమ్ కంటైన్ లైమ్ స్టోన్ శాండ్ స్టోన్ అండ్ సేల్ రాజస్థాన్ ఈస్ ద ప్రిన్సిపల్ ప్రొడ్యూసర్ ఆఫ్ జిప్సమ్ నెక్స్ట్ వీ షుడ్ డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్సెస్ వాట్ ఆర్ కాల్డ్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ ద ఎనర్జీ విచ్ ఈస్ యూస్డ్ టు జనరేట్ పవర్ దట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ దెర్ ఆర్ టూ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ నాన్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ ఆర్ నాన్ కన్వెన్షనల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ పొల్యూషన్ ఫ్రీ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ ఈకో ఫ్రెండ్లీ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ దే ఆర్ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ అబండెంట్ మెసర్స్ ఆఫ్టర్ మాస్ కన్సప్షన్ దే మే నాట్ బి లాస్ట్ దే మే బి రీప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ అండ్ రీగెయిన్డ్ రీయుటిలైజ్డ్ రీప్లెనిష్డ్ అగైన్ అండ్ అగైన్ బెస్ట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఆఫ్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ విండ్ పవర్ సోలార్ ఎనర్జీ టైడల్ ఎనర్జీ వేవ్ ఎనర్జీ బయోగ్యాస్ హైడల్ ఎనర్జీ నెక్స్ట్ నాన్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ నాన్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ ఆర్ కన్వెన్షనల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ నాట్ ఈకో ఫ్రెండ్లీ రిసోర్స్ దే కాస్ పొల్యూషన్ దే ఆర్ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ స్కార్స్ ఇన్ మెసర్స్ ఆఫ్టర్ మాస్ కన్సప్షన్ దే మే బి రిడ్యూస్డ్ దే కెనాట్ బి రీప్రొడ్యూస్డ్ అగైన్ అండ్ అగైన్ సో ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ టూ రిసోర్సెస్ యూ షుడ్ ప్రిజర్వ్ అండ్ కన్సర్వ్ ద నాన్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ డ్యూ టు ఫ్యూచర్ జనరేషన్ ఫార్ ద ప్రజెంట్ జనరేషన్ కంపల్సరీ షుడ్ యూస్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ కోల్ కోల్ ఈస్ ఎ నాన్ రెన్యూవబుల్ ఎనర్జీ రిసోర్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఆల్వేస్ లార్జ్లీ ఫౌండ్ ఇన్ లేయర్ ఆఫ్ ద సెడిమెంటరీ రాక్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ యూస్డ్ ఫార్ జనరేషన్ ఆఫ్ థర్మల్ పవర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఫార్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్ యాక్టివిటీస్ కోల్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ బ్లాక్ గోల్డ్ ఆన్ ద బేసిస్ ఆఫ్ కార్బన్ కాంటెంట్ కోల్ ఈస్ డివైడెడ్ టు ఫోర్ కేటగిరీస్ ఆంధ్రాసైట్ బిడుమినస్ లిగ్నైట్ అండ్ ఫీట్ ఆంధ్రాసైట్ విచ్ కంటైన్ 80-90% ఆఫ్ ద కార్బన్ కాంటెంట్ bituminous which contain 60 to 80% of the carbon content. Lignite contain 40 to 60% of the carbon content. Feed contains less than 40% of the carbon content. And the based on carbon content, anthracite is the best quality. Low quality feed. Coal is converted into gas, oil, liquid, power, electricity, thermal electricity. Coal is used for manufacturing of chemical dyes, fertilizer, paints, synthetic and explosive. Coal is used for manufacturing of chemical dyes, fertilizer, paints, synthetic and explosive. Chota Nagpur region which contributes 90% of the coal. Assam and Jammu and Kashmir which contributes 2% of the coal. Jharkhand which is the largest producer of coal in India. Jharkhand is the principal producer of coal in India. Next day, lignite. Lignite is called brown coal. Coal is called black gold. Lignite is called brown coal. It is largely found in Tamil Nadu, Kerala and Puducherry. Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Puducherry have high deposition of lignite. CIL. Expansion of CIL, Coal India Limited, it is located in Kolkata in West Bengal. It is the largest coal producing centers in the world. This organization comes under the control of Minister of Mines. It is the Government of India, public sector. It has number of offices. Its offices are located in different part of the country. For example, its offices are located in the Dhanbad, Ranchi, Bilaspur, Nagpur, Sambalpur. What is the expansion of CIL? Coal India Limited. Where it is located? Kolkata in West Bengal, which is the largest coal producing centers in the world. CIL. Where are its office located? Dhanbad, Ranchi, Bilaspur, Nagpur and Sambalpur. Petroleum. Petroleum word has been derived from Latin word, two words. Petro and oleum. Petro means rock. Oleum means oil. Extraction of oil from the rock of the earth is called petroleum. It is called mineral oil. Petroleum is used as a source of energy for automobile industry. Ships, aeroplanes and locomotives. Petrol is used as a fuel for vehicles, lubricants, kerosene, vaseline, tar, soap, turline and wax. These are petroleum byproducts. Lubricants, kerosene, vaseline, tar, soap, turline and wax. These are best example of petroleum products. Anso region which contributes 54% of the total production of the petroleum. Offshore region contributes 46%. What are the difference between onshore and offshore? Onshore, out of the sea. Offshore, inside the sea. Onshore region contributes 54% of the total production of the petroleum. Offshore region which contributes, say, 46% of the total production of the petroleum. There is a fluctuation of the petroleum in India. It's not evenly distributed, unevenly distribution of petroleum. What is the meaning of petro? Petro means a rock. What is the meaning of a oleum, oil? What is called petroleum, mineral oil? What is the contribution of onshore region? 54%. What is the contribution of offshore region? 46%. What are the byproduct of petroleum? Lubricants. Lubricants. Corrosion, Vaseline, tar and soap, Terlin and waxes, MOP and NG. What is the expansion of MOP and NG? Expansion of MOP and NG. Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Expansion of MOP and NG. Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. It is under the Minister of Mines, Public Sector, Government of India. It is responsible for exploration, distribution, mining, exporting, marketing, import, production, maintenance of entire activities of the petrol and natural gas under the MOP and the NG. What is the expansion of MOP and the NG? Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas. Western Coast Offshore Oil Fields. Western Coast Offshore Oil Fields. Western Coast, there are many types of oil fields. For example, Mumbai High Offshore Oil Field. Mumbai High Offshore Oil Field is the largest oil field in Western Coast. Gujarat Coast is the second largest oil field. Basin, Aliyabet, Ankleshwar, Kombi to Luni, Ahmedabad to Kalol. Bombay High Offshore Oil Field, it is the largest oil field in Western Coast. Gujarat Coast is the second largest oil field. Basim Oil Field, Aliyabet Oil Field, Ankleshwar Oil Field, Kombi to Luni Oil Field, Ahmedabad to Kalol Oil Field. Which is the largest oil field in Western Coast? Mumbai High Offshore Oil Field. Which is the second largest oil field which belongs to Western Coast? Gujarat Coast. What are the oil fields which are belonging to Eastern Coast? Eastern Coast Offshore Oil Fields. Eastern Coast Offshore Oil Fields. Brahmaputra Valley, Digboi, Nagarkatia, Moran Agrigian, Rudrasagar to Lava, Sarma Valley, Andaman Nicobar, Gulf of Mannar, Blaispur, Blaispur Coast, Balaispur Coast, Brahmaputra Valley, Digboi, Nagarkatia, Moran Agrigian, Rudrasagar to Lava, Sarma Valley, Andaman, Gulf of Mannar, Balaswar Coast. These are the very important oil fields which are found in Eastern Coast. Natural gas. What is natural gas? How it is formed? Natural gas are formed. Natural gas are formed when layer of the decayed animal and plants exposed into intense heat and pressure over the period of 1000 years. Natural gas are used as a source of energy for heating, cooking, and electricity generation. Natural gas are used as a fuel for vehicles. Natural gas are used for manufacturing of plastics and organic chemicals. Natural gas vehicles are utilized in Delhi, Bombay, Kolkata, Ahmedabad, Pune, Lucknow, Kanpur, and Varanasi. How natural gas are formed? Natural gas are formed when layer of the decayed plants and animals exposed into intense heat and pressure over the period of 1000 years. How natural gas are used as a source of energy? Natural gas is used as a source of energy for heating, cooking, and electricity generation. How is natural gas used as a fuel? Natural gas is used as a fuel for vehicles. Where are natural gas vehicles utilized in India? Natural gas vehicles are utilized in Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Ahmedabad, Pune, Lucknow, Kanpur, and Varanasi. Natural gas are largely mined in Bombay High Offshore Oil Field and Basim Oil Field. Where are natural gas largely mined? Natural gas are largely mined in Bombay High Offshore Oil Field and Basim Oil Field. GAIL. Expansion of GAIL. GAIL stands for Gas Authority of India Limited. It is doing pioneer work for discovery of gas in India. The first discovery of gas was made in 1985. Gas was discovered in Cauvery Delta regions. The major discovery of gas was made in 1988 to 1989. In recent, discovery of gas was made in Krishna and Godavari Delta region. What is the expansion of GAIL? Gas Authority of India Limited. When was the first discovery of gas made in India? 1985. When was major discovery of gas was made in India? 1988 to 1989. Where was discovery of gas was made in India recently? Krishna to Godavari Delta region. CNG. CNG stands for compressed natural gas. Expansion of CNG. CNG stands for compressed natural gas. It is used as a gasoline, diesel, propane, and LPG. LPG stands for liquid petroleum and gas. It is lighter than air when it is compared to natural gas and air. Natural gas is lighter than air. It disperses very quickly when it is released. Thermal power. Thermal power is produced from source of coal, petroleum, and natural gas.
coal, petroleum, natural gas are main source of electricity of thermal power. NTPC stands for Nuclear Power Corporation of India. Nuclear Power Corporation of India, it was launched in India in 1975. It consists of 13 coal-based super thermal power projects. It consists of 7 gas, liquid, oil, fuel-based combined cycle projects. NTPC, which contributes 90% of the total production of the thermal power. Tamil Nadu contributes 5% of the total production of the thermal power. In Tamil Nadu, there are many thermal power plants. For example, Mettur thermal power plants, Ennur thermal power plants, Thoothukudi thermal power plants, Neyveli thermal power plants. There are 4 important thermal power plants are found in Tamil Nadu. What are the source of thermal power plants? What are the source of generation of thermal power? Coal, petroleum and natural gas. When was Thermal Power Corporation started? 1975. What is the contribution of Thermal Power Corporation? 90%. What is the contribution of Tamil Nadu? 5%. Name the thermal power projects are found in Tamil Nadu. Mettur thermal power plants, Thoothukudi thermal power plants, Ennur thermal power plants, Neyveli thermal power plants. These are found in Tamil Nadu. NTPC, which includes 13 coal-based super thermal power projects. NTPC, which includes 7 gas, liquid, fuel, oil, combined cycle projects. Thermal power, it is one of the non-nuclear energy. Nuclear power is produced from source of uranium and thorium. The first nuclear power programs was started in India in 1940. Tata Atomic Energy Research Commission was started in India in 1948. First nuclear power projects was started in India at Tarapur near Mumbai in Maharashtra 1969. Its capacity 320 megawatt. Rawat Bhatta near Kota in Rajasthan. It is also another very important nuclear power plant. Its capacity 335 megawatt. Narora Atomic Power Plant in Uttar Pradesh. Its total capacity 235 megawatt. Kakrabara Atomic Power Plant in Gujarat. Its total capacity is 235 megawatt. Kaiga Atomic Power Plant in Karnataka, its total capacity 235 megawatt. Kalpakkam Atomic Power Plant in near Chennai in Tamil Nadu, its total capacity is 100 megawatt. Kalpakkam in Tirunelveli district in Tamil Nadu, with the collaboration of USSR, its total capacity 2000 megawatt. What are the source of generation of nuclear power? Source of generation of nuclear power, uranium and thorium. When was the first nuclear power programs launched? 1940. When was Tata Atomic Energy Commission started? 1948. Which is the first atomic power plant in India? Tarapur. Where is Tarapur? Tarapur lies very near to Mumbai in Maharashtra. When was Tarapur Atomic Power Plant started? 1969. What is the capacity of Tarapur? 320 megawatt. What is the capacity of Rawat Bhatta Kota near Rajasthan? 335 megawatt. Capacity of Narora 235 megawatt. Capacity of Kakrabara 235 megawatt. Capacity of Kaiga atomic power plant 235 megawatt. Capacity of the Kalpaka atomic power plant 100 megawatt. Capacity of the Kalpakam atomic power plant 2000 megawatt. 2000 megawatt. NPCIL, abbreviation of NPCIL. NPCIL stands for Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited. NPCIL stands for Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited. It was set up in Mumbai in Maharashtra. It is under the influence of the Minister of Mines, Government of India, Public Sector, Department of Atomic Energy is responsible for exploration of petroleum, exploration of nuclear power, distribution, exploration, mining, refining, marketing, export, import, distribution, production, conservation, preservation, entire activities of nuclear power programs in India is led by NPCIL. What is the expansion of NPCIL? Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited. Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited. Where this organization located? Mumbai in Maharashtra. Where it is influenced in India? It is under the influence of Minister of Mines. Whether it is a private sector or public sector, it is a public sector. It is under the control of Government of India. It plays a vital role for entire activities of nuclear power in India. Nuclear power in India. So in this lesson, we discuss all the non-metallic minerals, non-renewable resources. From the lesson, I would like to indicate some important location of minerals. For example, lignite. Lignite is largely mined in Kerala. Lignite is largely mined in Puducherry. Lignite is largely mined in Tamil Nadu. Mettur thermal power projects, Neyveli thermal power projects, Ennur thermal power projects, Thoothukudi thermal power projects are found in Tamil Nadu. In Karnataka, Kaiga atomic power plant is located in Karnataka. Karnataka is the leading producer of limestone. Andhra Pradesh is the leading producer of mica. In Maharashtra, the first atomic power plant, Tarapur, it was the first atomic power plant. It was located very near in Mumbai in Maharashtra. Basim oil field is also found in Maharashtra. Mumbai High Offshore Oil Field is also located in Maharashtra. Nuclear Power Corporation of India Limited is also located in Maharashtra. Kakrabara Atomic Power Plant in Gujarat. Rawat Bhatta near Kota in Rajasthan. Narora Atomic Power Plant in Uttar Pradesh. Rajasthan is the leading producer of gypsum. Then NALCO stands for National Aluminium Corporation of India Limited, which was located in Odisha. CIL, Coal India Limited, Colonial Limited is an organization. It was located in Kolkata in West Bengal. Kolkata in West Bengal. Then related this lesson, we explained some important centers where it is located. Just a map also very important. Without map, if you prepare the lesson should not be understood. With the map, go through the lesson and update your knowledge. Thank you very much.